one road. Switching lanes to change my fortune.
At the beginning of the season, we had been dominating all fall ball. We were just excited to play our normal season. I was just excited to play with the girls again for one more time.
Going into opening night, I think we were all really excited and pumped and ready to get the season started. I really remember warm-ups. Normally, I'm just trying to dial in, get ready for the game, but I couldn't help all the students starting to come in and watching the students go row by row. It was really intimidating, but during announcements, I looked up and I started smiling because I knew this was going to be a good day. Halfway through the season, we started talking about serious goals that we wanted to set moving forward. Some of those were limiting turnovers and fouls, but also beating the opponents on the boards. And as we continue to do that game in and game out, we continued to win games and build our confidence and ended out the season 16-1. This is what I was made to do. I was born.
Going into senior night, I was just not even thinking anything of it except for all the years before where I was in select and we watched all the games and all the older girls. But once we got to the week of, everything started to dial up and on social media, all the posts were coming through and everything, and it really felt real at that point. So I was just very excited. And then once my nerves were kicking in, and then once the game started, I was just locked in and settled in and score the first two baskets somehow, but yeah, it was a really good night. towards the end of the game, we had a timeout and it was rushed with urgency because we really needed to stop the clock in the next couple seconds to get our seniors out of the game. And shout out to Jordan because she put her heart into it and she went out with a bang with just this big foul, and it was just so much fun to watch.
Starting off the first game in the Kinko tournament, we were up against North Creek. We played them once. We knew what we had to do. The coaches came out with a good game plan, and we went out and executed it. What y'all think? Everything that you say about me. My dog is like a play mad in a 2K. But one thing I don't do is play about me. My homeboy Tyler, he playing South Beach. He told me this summer he gon' fix my jumper. I told boy Wonder that we might got a thumper. I've been tryna pop, now I'm on like Shumper. Now they on my bumper. Green room chock full of all my comforts. Hotel room like heaven on earth. Got angels in my bed with some all white covers. Going into the second game of the Kinko tournament, we knew that Inglemore was going to be our opponent, and we were just excited because we knew their players, we'd played them before, and we were just ready to get work done and keep advancing in the tournament. I can sell y'all boys, I tried it back then. Boy, now I'm in a box like a Kellogg's toy. The ones that hate me the most are just like me. You tell me what that means, make a slick comment and see what that brings. I've seen it go down, we can reenact things. Extreme like DMXing. And they PMSing. People in the city see the movement occurring and say, my God, I wanna be in that scene. Right, you wanna be in this scene. She had the video trying to be in this scene. Used to fantasize about being this scene. Bluegrass girl, but she got big dreams. After a tough loss against Woodinville, I just remember being in the locker room with all the girls and we were really upset, but I just remember Goldie saying that there's no other place that she'd rather be than with us girls. And that really just gave us confidence going into the next game.
Having played Inglemore the week before, we already knew what we were up against, but this time there was a lot more tension and emotions going on off the court. So we just came together as a team and decided that we were just gonna keep everything on the court and we were gonna win by executing the game plan, and we ended up taking another win against Inglemore the following week. It was the start of regionals, and we were already packed and fueled with vengeance, knowing that we were going to play Lake Stevens again. We came in with a new game plan and executed it and ended up coming out on top.
The day we left for state, we didn't have a game, but the coaches let us go and watch a game just to get the feel for the dome. And walking in on the floor, just being under the lights, it was just such a special moment to know we had made it and we were there, and we were there to come home with a trophy.
Going into the state tournament, we were just so excited to play at the Dome. We've been waiting for this experience for so long. We were right where we needed to be. Our nerves were through the roof, but we were so happy to be where we were. At the end of the Emerald Ridge game, T-Money clutched up with the game-winning shot that put us in the spot to have that semifinal game against Woodinville. There was no better feeling than running out onto that court with all my girls, just knowing that we were gonna play in the semifinal game at the state tournament.
We are super fortunate to have such an amazing coaching staff that put together two amazing game plans, both for Woodinville and Pasco, that gave us the confidence we needed to bring both those games to a very close score. We ended up losing both those games, but came home with a fifth place trophy, which we are super proud of, as it shows our connections and teamwork throughout the whole year.
Honestly, I don't think I have a favorite moment from the season. I think that this entire season was my favorite season out of the four. And as a senior, knowing that I couldn't have done any better, I was very happy. Now your mess is mine.
About a month into our season, we ended up playing Burlington Edison on a game that our coaches scrambled to get us, which we were very thankful for. And it was one of my favorite memories of the season because Schmitty and Kay were able to teach us a handshake that the entire team learned and ended up becoming a ritual before every single game.
On average, Ava Schmidt probably swats me once every practice, and one practice, I don't know what it was, but I went up there and I swatted her in a drill and everyone went crazy, and I'm just so glad everyone saw it. It was my favorite moment ever, and so Schmitty, got you back. This mess was yours. Now your mess is mine.
I just want to give a special shout out to the coaches, Coach Meggs, Coach Goldie, Coach Laura, Coach Bruns, and Coach Nicole for being always there for us. We wouldn't be where we are without you guys. Being thankful is an understatement, and we love you guys so much, and we're going to miss you.